Hello, everyone. I'm just going to wait a couple minutes here. I'm a little few minutes early. Hello, I'm so excited. I'm doing my first Facebook Live. Yeehaw! Today I am going to show you how to do our first my calendar and my post-it note holder that I'm going to be making for you. But first, while I'm waiting for people to join, I'm going to start off with showing you our new catalogs. I am so excited about these catalogs. They're wonderful to me, of course. Plus, they have butterflies, so of course we're going to be using butterflies today. Hello. But let's start with our celebration. For every $50 that you spend, you get to get a free product out of our celebration brochure. There's so many beautiful things. I'll get back to this in a second. This is the Hello Cupcake with the ribbon. And we have bought more butterflies. This paper, let me tell you, people, the Botanical Butterfly Designer Series, people, paper, I mean, beautiful. I already have three packs of it. Shh, don't tell anyone. You get to do some, this one is really good by the bay if you like to color. And we have the Home de Roost. Look at these cute frogs. Are they just adorable? And this foil paper, this picture does no justice. Hi, Brittany. Hi, Roslyn. I will try to get to comments. I'm trying to watch both of them at the same time. Part of my story, this one's really pretty. We're actually going to be using this one. We're going to use, know that today a friend is thinking of you. And the lovely lattice, this one's really pretty too. And we have a card kit here, the tea framelits that go with the tea set in our occasions catalog. Okay, can I just tell you, ladies and gentlemen, this set is beautiful. It is called Lasting Lily. And I had this at my customer appreciation yesterday. We did a card with it. Everyone loved it. Hi, Mary. So that is really pretty. You'll be seeing lots of that on my blog at stampinscrapper.com. Go there, and I try to post every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, and sometimes I will post in between when important things come up. This is our occasions catalog. Let me just tell you. Let me flip through these pages. Beautiful. Look at these. Oh, guess what? This is the one we're going to use today. This is the gingham gala. It is on page 34 and 35, and it is gorgeous because it has butterflies in it. But I just love the Gingham Gala Designer Series paper. And I have everything here to show you what comes in this suite because it is so beautiful. To start off with, let me show you. This is the stamp set we're going to use. So let me get this out of the way. Toss that off to the side so it's not in our way. Okay, this is the stamp set we're going to use. This is called Butterfly Gala. And what I love about it is you get four different designs of the butterfly. But look, you can get it as a bundle. I'm trying not to glare on my, you're getting a glare, I apologize. You get the bundle, you get the butterfly punch, and the stamp set, which is awesome because guess what Stampin' Up! Did this time? Remember when it used to have here, let's see if you can see it better. Okay, remember when before when you had two different things to punch out of the one punch when you did it once, you'd have to try to figure out how to line them up? Guess what Stampin' Up! Did this time? They put them together. They're connected. How cool is that? And here's a little trick that I shared with my customers yesterday that I always want to know, okay, what designs are this different butterflies? Because you can see there are four different designs on here. Well, which one do I want to use? I stamped all four of them on a piece of paper so I could see better the design. Then I just stick it in here and I've got it and it's ready to go. I don't have to worry about it anymore. Just pick up that piece of paper and I'm set to go. And here, let me take this. Oh, we're going to need to use this. I'll set that over here. This is the paper. How beautiful is this? We have the Lemon Lime Twist, Daffodil Delight, Grapefruit Grove, Balmy Blue, and Highland Heather. I have already made these two, and I'll show you this again. I'll show you them in a minute. But we're going to use the grapefruit grove today with the Calypso coral. So that's the one we're going to do today. Then you can get this beautiful ribbon. Oh, I love it. And then to put a little sparkle on your projects, look at these beautiful sequins. You get 5 different sheets. This one's got a pink. It kind of changes a little bit of color. We have a yellow, a purple, a green, and this one is a multicolor one. Just beautiful. I know the picture's not giving us any justice on that. So let's get started with our project. Okay, this is what I made for my customers yesterday. I had a customer event, appreciation event yesterday, and this was my goodies to them, my thank you gifts. So we made, here it is in the balmy blue, we made, it's a calendar that stands up. I know it's hard to tell on there, but it stands up. See, it has this great V in there to help it stand up. And then I made a little post-it note cover. And you know what the best part is? This took 1 sheet of designer series paper. That's it. And you have 2 little strips left over. You can do something else with them. So it is great to get a lot out of 1 set of DSP. And here it is done. And the Highland Heather, beautiful. I love purple. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and get started on making one. First, we're going to start off with the calendar. Okay, so on the calendar, you're going to need a piece of 4 1/4 by 11, and you're going to score it at 5 1/2. Then you're going to need another piece at 4 1/8 by 5 3/8. Then this one is going to be 3 3/8 by 2 5/8. And up. I think I'm missing a piece. Oh no, did I really? Let me see here. Nope, I guess I'm right. I'm right. That's all we had in that color. Okay. And then in our grapefruit grove, I have I told you totally wrong. Of course I did, because it's my first time and I screwed up. Let's start all over. Okay, we're starting over. Okay, what you're going to do, this is the grapefruit grove. And you're going to do this one at 4 1/4 by 11, scored at 5 1/2. This one you're going to do at 4 by 5, and you're going to score at 1, 2 1/2, and 4. And then we have a piece at 2 1/2 and 3 1/4. I will have all these measurements. I'll go back in and I'll put them in and I'll link it to the blog post. This blog post will go up on Tuesday. This, now the Calypso Coral. We're going to be at 4 1/8 by 5 3/8. And then we have our 2 5/8 by 3 3/8. And our 1 1/8 by 2 1/2. Then we have our designer series paper. You're going to do this at 4 5 1/4. And then I just grabbed some scraps for to do our, where did I put it? To do our sentiment and for the butterflies to stamp those. So we have some scrap papers for those. So let's end. I got my calendars from Tailored Expressions. And they're the set of 10. You can get a set of 10 of these for $3. Very, very inexpensive. Okay, so let's get started. This first one I was gonna do my scoring here, but I kind of forgot and scored this one. So this one's already scored. This is scored at 5 1/2. Oops, I forgot my bone folder. I knew I'd forget something. Let me quick grab that. Oh, where did it go? Here we go. Okay. We're gonna do this and use your bone folders because you want that crisp fold there. Then you're going to take your Calypso core, wrong one. Your grapefruit grove. You want to take that one. And you're going to score this at, I'm using my scoring tool. Love this, love it. You have, your stylus has 2 points. It has a bigger point and a smaller point. The smaller point is for your cardstock. Your bigger point is for the DSP so that it doesn't rip your paper because some of our DSP is thinner. And DSP, I mean by designer series paper. So we're going to score this at 1 inch, 2 1/2 inch, and 4 inch. Set that off to the side. Oops. Okay. So we're going to want this to look like I just need to set this off to the side up here, don't I? We want it to look like a W is what we're trying to do here with this piece. So what I do is I fold it in half first, and then I bring my flaps down to me, again, using my bone folder, because you want those crisp lines. Now, since this piece is going to be holding our, making it for a tent to hold up, hold it still, I want to use a really strong adhesive because I want to be able to keep it securely together. So what I'm going to use is I'm going to use our tear and tape. And I put two strips down this, one near each edge. So you're just going to put it on here. What's nice about this tape is you don't need scissors if you don't want to. You can just tear it or you can use scissors. Sometime my OCD-ness kicks in and I got to use my scissors, I'll be honest, because I don't like the jagged edges, but for this video, we're going to tear it. Now, you guys all can see my nails. They're long, they're hard. You know, this sometimes are hard to get off, so I use a pair of tweezers. And I just pull this off and it comes right off, no problem. Take this, whoops. And we're going to take this one. Come on, bugger. It's going to be stubborn this afternoon. I should say it's not morning anymore, is it? Okay, so then we're going to take our folded piece here. This is our folded that we already did. And we're going to line this folded edge up. Let's see if I can get this in the camera so you can see. You're going to line this up perfectly with this. Now, you're going to have a little bit on each side because this is cut at 4 inches. And this is cut at 4 1/4. So you don't want it to go all the way to the end. You just want to bring it in a little bit. It looks neater. And then all I'm doing is folding this down. Hold this down. Bring this up and fold it down. And it's perfectly lined up. And voila, you've got your tent. It's going to stand out for you. Now, let's decorate our front. So first we're going to start with our Calypso Coral piece. This is the 5 3/8 by 4 1/8. And just use snail on this. Put that on here. Now you're only going to have a small border around it. See how I have a very small border around here? One way that I have taught my customers to do this is to make sure that your paper is always lined up perfectly. If you center it on three sides, so I'm going to center on this side, this side, and this side, and make sure they're the same distance around. If you do that, I hold it in place. Whoops, needs to go up just a little. Let me see here, make sure. Okay, I did. I was afraid I cut this the same size. Okay, and then I did mess up the size, I think. Oh, sugar, let me check again. There we go. Let's try this again. I did on this one. I cut it too long. Let me check my other piece. This is why I cut a second piece to make sure I had it right. There, this one's better. Let's use this one. I made that one a little too long. So if I was doing this and not on camera, I would have gone and trimmed it. But I had a second one cut just in case I made mistakes like this. So there we go. Much better. And then we're going to take our DSP. Now, I want to show you a little trick with the designer series paper. Our paper comes in sheets of 6x6. Let me grab a piece out here. They come in the 6x6 piece. You can use the big checks or the little checks. And what I did was I went ahead and I wrote this out so you could see what I did. Let me move this so it's flat. This started off with 6x6. I cut it at 4 inches down. And then I cut at 5 1/4. So that gave me this piece that we're going to use now on the calendar. So you're going to have this little strip. You want to save that because you can use that on another card. You're going to have this strip that's 2 inches by 6 inches. You're going to cut it at 3 1/4 because we're going to use that one on our notebook pad, our post-it notepad holder. So we're going to use that again. You're going to have this little piece left over, which is great because you can use that on another project. So you're going to get both projects out of one piece of designer series paper, which is wonderful. Okay, let's get back to this one. So we're going to go ahead and put this on and make sure you put it on the side that you don't want showing up. Like I was working on a bunch of them, because I made over 30 of these, and I did it on the wrong side. I was like, oh, goodness. So guess what? That one looked a little bit different than the others. And you lay it down again. I lined up these three here to make sure that they were centered, dropped it down, smooth it out, and guess what? It's all done. Excuse me. So we're going to go ahead now and do the base here. We're going to work on the calendar base right now. So we're just going to go ahead and put these on here. I'm using snail. Some of the times I was using fast fuse on some of these just to make sure they held up, but today we're just going to use the snail on this. Okay, but for the back of it, I did use fast fuse. I think it's still on the clearance rack. If not, you can use the tear and tape. But for today, I'm going to use a fast fuse because it's a little bit faster. Okay, we're going to put that. Oops. And I went up, I want to say about two lines is what I went up. And I tried to center it. Now, one thing when you use a fast fuse, once it's down, you're not going to get it up. So you want to make sure you have it right where you want it. So we'll put it right there and suppress it down. The next thing we need to do is some stamping. So let's get out our stamps. Now, for this second one, I am using for our sentiment, it's called Part of My Story. We're going to use the one that says, know that today a friend is thinking of you. And that's what I used as the sentiment up here for it. So let's go ahead and get that stamped. Now, we're going to do the stamping for this one in the Calypso Coral because I want it darker. So we can put it on here, stamp it. And I just took a scrap piece of white paper. Whoops, let me make sure it's up here so you can see it. Hopefully you can see this. Okay, there we go. And we're going to go ahead and clean this. And have you guys seen our new chamois? I love this. I will tell you at first, I was a little skeptical on it, but I started using it. I don't know what took me so long. I love this. Look at wipe, wipe, wipe. It's done. It's clean, ready to go. Now, one thing I do want to tell you about this is called our new cling stamps. With the cling stamps, oh, I didn't grab a new one. Let me see if I have a new one here that hasn't been opened yet. Here we go. They're going to come like this. So you're going to have this one. This is, which one am I playing with? Stamping Your Way to the Top. It's going to be, your sheets are going to come like this, just like normal. But to put these together, I'm going to give you a quick little lesson here. To put these together, we're going to do this one right here. This is a demonstrator stamp set that we can get. I probably should have grabbed one that you guys can get. I apologize. I just grabbed one that was sitting here. But you're going to take off the paper here to adhere it. Remember when our old ones, we took off the label, we stuck it on here trying to make sure it's lined up? Well, you don't do that anymore. This is our new cling stamps. And they are clinging, let me tell you. But they are fabulous. You're going to want to take that off and leave that in there. Then you're going to take your stamp and you're going to line it up right on the line. So I'm trying to do this without getting my head in there. There we go. And you line up. And guess what? Voila, you are done and it is on. And it is sticky. See how sticky it is? Now with this, let me put this back in here. I want to show you how to take them off of the block. You don't rip them like our old ones. You just could pair off. You don't want to do that. You want to make sure you get under the sticky. But guess what? I've had this on since yesterday when I prepped for this. So I'm going to take our new take your pick tool. And I'm going to use the spatula part. And I just lightly go under it to get it started. And then I take my finger and I can gently lift it off the block like that. And away you go. And it is so fabulous because they don't move. See, you can rub it, and this is perfect for the Stamparatus too. And when you're cleaning it, it stays on the block. You don't have to worry about it falling off, which is really nice, especially when you are doing, you have a sentiment like this and you need it perfectly lined up, that you want to make sure that it doesn't move. And now you can with the new cling. They are wonderful. Okay, so went to cut this out. I'm not going to use my big shot today to show you. I used our new rectangle stitched framelits. They are awesome. and so pretty. So what I did was I used the smallest one here. You're going to get 13 of these in the set. I'm using this. I cut it out with that, and that's what you get here. But I do want to show you quick a card made yesterday. I don't remember the lady that showed this online, but she made a card. Oh, shoot, I forgot to take it out of the plastic. She made one like this to show the different layers of the frameless. Isn't that neat? You get so many. And this used all of these except for the last one here. It used all of the frames so you can see the different sizes. You also have these here, and then you have this little one here too. Lots and lots of possibilities with that. I love those. So we're going to pretend that I cut that with a big shot. Here we go. So we're going to go ahead and put this on our Calypso Coral paper. And again, do your three sides. That is what's going to make sure everything is lined up perfectly. And put it on. And then I put this on with dimensionals. So I'm just going to go ahead and stick this on my project. Forgot to grab my little garbage can too. I'll have to remember that for next time. So this one I just kind of centered here. I'll do it. This one we got. I centered it on here, and I want to leave a little bit room up here because I'm going to be putting a butterfly. Of course, we're going to be putting butterflies on there. Okay, so we'll do. Oh, right. Now we want to make. I'm putting this back in. We're going to do our butterflies. And I'm going to stamp enough of those butterflies, and I'm going to just stamp the ones for this too at the same time. So we'll have them all ready to go. So we're going to take again our Calypso Coral for this one. Let me move that out of our way. And let me grab my stamp. And what's nice, I don't know if you can see this, but let me quick clean this and I'll show you, try to show it to you again. Okay, when you're using the photopolymer, this part is really nice because you can see, hopefully you guys can see this. Let me bring it up. You can see, can you see that? Okay, you can see the ink going onto the stamp, so you know you have it all covered. So you're gonna take that, and I have a long piece of paper here I'm just gonna use. Again, use a piece of scrap, that's all you need. Put it here. We're gonna do two of these. The one, two. Then, let me clean this again, because if you notice on my project here, I'm going to put this one out here because it's a little bit smaller. It doesn't take up so much room. See the little light colored butterfly I used? But I just want the little part right here. So that, I brought in the Calypso, Grapefruit Grove one. And I'm only going to ink up the very top one. So you ink it up. And if you get a little bit of the bottom, it's not a big deal. And I'm going to stamp it towards the bottom because I don't want to punch out the whole big butterfly. I just want to punch out my little one. So there we go. Clean this. Oh, and one thing I learned about my chamois, and I didn't know this the first time, and I will tell you, I hadn't used them for a while. I'd just been busy using my wipes. And I went to open it, and it had mold on it. Like, why does it have mold? What did I do? So I called our demo just support, and let me tell you, stamping up is fabulous with knowledge and to help you. But what she told me is there's a couple tricks with this. Number one, don't wring it. You want to squeeze it like this to get your water out, and you want to leave it, get it, you know, as much water out as you can, and leave it. And these cases are perfect. This is our single cases that our stamps come in. You can order these, and you can store things in them. I use them for rhinestone pearls, embellishments. But just leave it in here and leave it open until it is damp, and then close it. Mine had too much moisture in it, and I left it closed too long, and that's why I got mold on it. So I bought some more. Now I know not to do that. Okay, so we're going to get our punch out. And this is what's so nice. It will line up here. So you're going to line it up. Okay, let's see here. That looks good. Punch. And we're going to punch another one. So how is everyone doing on this beautiful Sunday afternoon. I appreciate you guys so much for stopping in and seeing me. Hey, if you guys could, if you could pop share this on your page, I would love that. That way I can get out to more people. Okay, now see, to do the little one, I'm just punching out the top. There we go. And so we're gonna do this one. Oops, let me grab it over here. Get that lined up. There we go. I say there you go a lot, so you'll hear that from me. All right, and you know what? I need my glue dots. Quick grab those. Thought I had everything. I knew I'd forget something. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and we're going to put our butterflies together. We're going to want to do, I use glue dots for the little butterflies. They just work perfect for adhering them. So I put them on, when I'm doing a bunch of them like this, I will go ahead and get them all on here. And then this handy dandy tool again, I'm gonna pull this off because I want the other end. So I unlock it, flip it. Look at those lined up. You need to line up, there's grooves here to line up and twist it again. And then I just take that like this, and you can use the spatula part too, but for me, I like the pointy part. And I'm just gonna lay it on here where I want it. Oops. Oh, it's stuck. I didn't want it to stick yet. Okay. And put that one there. We're gonna grab this one, and we're gonna put it in the middle. Okay, it keeps moving on me today. Of course it does. And we're gonna put it right there. Okay, so for these little guys though, I used the mini dimensionals, and these are perfect for these. Now, because I want this to go over my sentiment a little bit, you're gonna want to put your mini dimensional, and you only need one of these, you're gonna put it towards the top, right here. There we go. Okay, so then you're gonna peel that off. And I put it right there. And then I'm gonna put my little dark one right here. Okay, now we can put our calendar on. And I'm gonna have to tell you guys, I have a confession to make. I didn't order enough of these. So I took these off another one to put on here. So you're gonna see it came off a balmy blue. So you're gonna see that on the back of it. Shh, don't tell anyone. All right, then now my tape probably isn't gonna stick to it. Of course not. So let's get our tear and tape out. That will stick. My roller didn't wanna stick on it because it already has paper on the back of it because I didn't order enough. I don't know what I was thinking of, but I definitely didn't order enough of these when I need to make about 60 of them. And I only ordered enough for 30. What was I thinking? Okay, it's sticking to me because it has that other tape on it too. So I do go a kind of heavy with the tape for the calendars. Number one, I want them to stay in place. Number two, because your people are gonna be ripping off the other months and I want it to stay on there. I don't want it to be falling off for them. Again, I'm gonna bring in my tweezers and tear this off. This is great for people with nails. And you will see I am neurotic about my nails. I love my nails. Oh, I got glue on it. They're gonna be colorful today too. And so I use the tweezers. So we're gonna put these on and we're gonna line them up. Again, I'm gonna turn this so, whoops, I got tape. Oh, now let me take that off. Oh goodness, it's sticking to me everywhere, isn't it? Ah! Okay, that's what jeans are for, right? Wipe them on your jeans. Again, I'm going to center it the three sides and lay it down and press it down. Now, while I'm working on the project, oh my goodness, I have that blue everywhere, don't I? While I'm working on my projects, I keep the cover on it until I'm finished. And then you just take off the top piece, and there you go. You have your new calendars, but wait a minute. It's kind of boring, isn't it? It needs bling. So let's bring in our rhinestones, and I put one in the center of my butterfly, and one in the center. Come here, little bugger. of this butterfly. Just for a little bling, and there you go. That is how you make the calendar. Now, let's make the post-it note, and let me tell you, this is even easier. Okay, it's on there. I'm like, where'd my little butterfly go? We'll put those off to the side. This is what we're gonna make now. Cute little post-it note. So what you're gonna take for this one is, you see my cheat sheet? So I know what sizes to tell you. Okay, this is gonna be cut at 7 by 3/4. The Calypso Coral is 2 1/8 by 3 1/4. Our designer series paper is 2 inches by 3 1/4. And this is our little post-it note. So for this one, let me move these out of our way so I got room. We want to get out our scoring tool. And this one, you're going to score at 3 1/4 and 3 3/4. And that's it. That's all you do. And you can get 3 of these out of 1 sheet of cardstock. Let me get my bone folder. You're going to score on our score lines again, because remember, we want crisp lines. Whenever you're doing a 3D project, you want to make sure you are using your score lines. I mean, your bone folder, to get those straight, crisp lines. Okay, let's do our decorating. Here we go. I'll put this here so you guys can see what we're making. Okay, I like to lay it flat because it's easier to put together. So we're going to use our snail adhesive again. Put this on. Now this one, because we're going the whole length, it's going to be covered. I don't have a border on the sides. So you just want to get it. Oh, it's moving on me. You want to get it centered in between the two. There we go. Okay, again, because we're going to be using this a lot. Okay, I'm not sure if this is going to work because I got that blue on it, but we'll try. If this doesn't work, we'll get our tear and tape again. But I go ahead and do this, and remember with your fast fuse, if you use it, do your check marks and alternate back and forth, which way you do your checks to keep this on the roller correctly. I'm just centering this. I'm just eyeballing it to make sure it's where I want it. Okay, now with this butterfly, I realized that I had put it towards the top because I was thinking I was doing 2 of them. I usually do it at the bottom, but it doesn't really matter. It's going to stick no matter what. So you're going to put this one on here. Okay, I'm going to take this little guy off again using our take your pick tool. Love this tool. Oops. And I just kind of set him like this. We're going to go ahead and add our 2 rhinestones again because we got to have bling. You got butterflies, you got to have bling. Okay, this one. And I apologize if I'm not catching the comments at the same time I'm trying to catch comments as they come up. Okay, so now we're going to put on our post-it note. Now, because again, people are going to be tearing it off, we want it to stay secure. So I am going to use my tear and tape for this. And I just put one, and I put 3 of them on. I did 1 on the top, 1 in the middle, and 1 at the bottom. So that way it's going to stay secure. Okay, tweezers, here we go. Grab that. Oh, goodness. Now it doesn't want to come off. Let's try again. Okay, try this side. There we go. You should see my desk over here on the side. I've been just throwing my trash over here. It's a mess. And if anyone knows me, they know I hate a mess. So I'm not going to show you though, because I'm not going to let you know I made a mess. All right. And just center it again. I centered it on all 4 sides and close it. And there you go. You have a beautiful calendar and note set. And it'll be perfect for anyone that gets this. They're going to love this. And actually, this one is going on my desk because I love this color. This and navy blue are my 2 favorite colors. Thank you so much for joining me today. I hope you, enjoyed it. I had a lot of fun, and I will be doing these more, and hopefully soon I will be doing these weekly. Thank you, and have a great day, guys. Bye-bye.